The 1975 movie The Fortune brings together two classic Hollywood actors, Jack Nicholson and Warren Beatty, in a comedic caper that takes us on a journey filled with humor and unexpected twists. It's a film that showcases their impeccable on-screen chemistry, leaving you with the question, which of these iconic actors was your favorite in this delightful romp? Now, let's dive into the heart of the matter and explore some interesting tidbits about the movie. But before we do, we're curious to know, what's your most cherished memory or personal experience related to The Fortune? We'd love to hear your stories and memories in the comments below. Did you know that The Fortune was directed by Mike Nichols, known for his knack in blending comedy and drama? The film is set in the 1920s and follows the misadventures of two hustlers who get caught up in a web of romantic entanglements and get-rich-quick schemes. The story unfolds with a comedic charm that keeps you engaged from start to finish. Now that we've piqued your interest with a taste of this classic Hollywood gem, we eagerly await your memories and stories related to The Fortune. Share your thoughts in the comments below, and let's relive this cinematic treasure together. The Fortune is a 1975 comedy film directed by Mike Nichols, and stars Warren Beatty, Jack Nicholson, and Stockard Channing. Set in the 1920s, the film revolves around two bumbling con artists, Nicky and Oscar, who plan to marry a wealthy and mentally unstable young woman, Freddie, with the hope of inheriting her fortune. As they try to pull off the scheme, their hilariously inept antics and clashes with the unpredictable Freddie lead to a series of comedic misadventures. The movie is known for its charismatic performances by Beatty and Nicholson, who play iconic characters with distinct personalities. Beatty's suave and charming Nicky contrasts sharply with Nicholson's clumsy and foolish Oscar, creating a dynamic that drives the film's humor. Stockard Channing's portrayal of the unpredictable Freddie adds to the chaos, making the characters memorable and endearing to the audience. The Fortune stands out with its unique style, blending elements of screwball comedy and farce, creating a fast-paced and laugh-out-loud experience. The film's zany humor and witty dialogue have contributed to its status as a cult classic, although it was not a commercial success upon release. While it may not have left a significant mark on popular culture, it remains a hidden gem appreciated by fans of classic comedy. In summary, The Fortune is a delightful comedic romp with unforgettable characters and a distinctive style that continues to entertain audiences who appreciate its offbeat humor. In 1975, before the movies were released, Columbia Pictures was certain it had two hits in this movie, and Funny Lady, and Two Bombs in Tommy, and Shampoo. In actuality, the exact opposite proved to be true. The Fortune, a 1975 comedy film directed by Mike Nichols, was anticipated to be a success by Columbia Pictures, along with Funny Lady. However, things didn't go as expected. While the studio believed these two movies would be hits, the reality turned out quite differently. The Fortune didn't achieve commercial success, despite the initial high hopes. This contrast between expectations and reality highlights the unpredictability of the film industry during that time. It serves as a reminder that even with the best predictions, the fate of a movie can be quite different when it hits the screens. This behind-the-scenes insight into the expectations and outcomes of The Fortune provides a glimpse into the dynamics of the film industry in 1975. It's a reminder that success and failure in the movie business can often defy predictions. Opening credits prologue. During the 1920s, in the United States, the law known as the Mann Act was much feared. It prohibited transporting a woman across state lines for immoral purposes. Because of the Mann Act, a man who wanted to run off with a woman and was willing or unable to marry her would sometimes go to unusual lengths. This unique historical context sets the stage for the 1975 movie The Fortune, directed by Mike Nichols, adding depth to the film's comedic escapades. Interestingly, Joel Coen and Ethan Coen, acclaimed filmmakers in their own right, have both named this film as one of their favorites, highlighting its enduring appeal and influence in the world of cinema. It's a testament to the film's lasting impact on the industry. Credited theatrical movie debut of Stockard Channing. In the 1975 movie The Fortune, Stockard Channing made her credited theatrical movie debut, portraying the unpredictable character Freddie. This marked a significant milestone in her acting career. While the film itself may not have achieved commercial success, it provided a platform for Channing to showcase her talent and begin her journey in the world of cinema. Her performance in The Fortune laid the foundation for a successful and enduring career in film and television. In her 2016 autobiography, The Princess Diarist, Carrie Fisher mentioned that she auditioned for the 1975 movie The Fortune. This audition provides a glimpse into the casting process of the film, shedding light on the talented individuals considered for roles. While Fisher may not have been part of the final cast, her audition is a part of the movie's history. It underscores the meticulous efforts taken in assembling the ensemble for this comedy film. The Fortune, despite not achieving the commercial success expected, remains a notable piece of cinematic history, enriched by the participation of various talented actors and actresses. It's a reminder of the intricacies behind the scenes in the world of film. The film The Fortune from 1975 boasts a notable cast, including two Oscar winners, Warren Beatty and Jack Nicholson, along with two Oscar nominees, Stockard Channing and Christopher Guest. It's interesting to note that Jack Nicholson made this movie while waiting for production on One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest to start. Additionally, the film features Harry Dean Stanton in a supporting role, adding to its ensemble of talented actors. These aspects contribute to the film's place in cinematic history, showcasing the caliber of talent involved in its production. The Fortune remains a piece of 1970s cinema worth exploring. Director Mike Nichols faced a tough time with The Fortune in 1975. This marked his second consecutive film that didn't go as planned. The experience of making the movie was far from pleasant for him. It's worth noting that Nichols, unlike some other directors, preferred a congenial atmosphere on set and a good time during filming. Unfortunately, The Fortune didn't provide that, and it turned out to be another flop for him. In fact, things didn't get much better for Nichols in the years that followed. He didn't direct another feature film for 8 years, and his next venture, Silkwood, didn't come until 1983. The challenges he faced with The Fortune and the subsequent setbacks highlight the unpredictability of the film industry. Even experienced directors like Nichols can have a tough time in Hollywood. This article delves into the challenges faced by director Mike Nichols during the making of The Fortune and how it influenced his career in the years to come. It's a reminder that success in the movie business can often defy predictions. As we draw the curtains on our journey through the captivating world of the 1975 movie The Fortune, I invite you to take a moment to reflect on the personal connection that this cinematic gem has forged within you. This timeless classic has undoubtedly left an indelible mark on the hearts and minds of countless viewers, and your experience is no exception. Perhaps you were entranced by the spellbinding performances of the talented cast, reveling in the comedic brilliance of Warren Beatty, Jack Nicholson, and Stockard Channing. Maybe the film's exquisite cinematography and period-accurate sets transported you to the glitzy and glamorous 1920s, allowing you to feel the allure of a bygone era. Or it's possible that the film's witty humor and intriguing storyline left you with unforgettable memories and a lasting appreciation for its unique charm. Now is the perfect moment to share your favorite memories, thoughts, or personal anecdotes about The Fortune. Whether it's a particular scene that made you laugh uncontrollably, a character whose quirks you couldn't help but adore, or the underlying themes that left you pondering, your insights are a valuable part of the legacy of this cinematic masterpiece. We encourage you to engage with us and fellow enthusiasts to celebrate the joy and magic that The Fortune brings to our lives. Your voice adds depth to the collective love for this film, and together we can ensure its legacy endures for generations to come. Thank you for joining us on this nostalgic and delightful journey through the world of The Fortune. Your time and interest are greatly appreciated. We look forward to hearing your thoughts and memories about this beloved classic. Until then, keep the spirit of The Fortune alive, and remember that this outro was...